This is how your computer can look if you don't clean your system for 6 months. That's exactly what I did. You guys asked me for it. It's an open case. Belongs actually to my wife. Her channel name is written there. Everything is gonna be flying here. It's super dusty. I'm using a vacuum cleaner from Parkside. It has a blowing functionality as well. 200 watt will do the job just fine. You can see the dust particles flying everywhere. Normally you want to do it outside, but it was super heavy and I didn't want to drag it outside since it was cold. I ended up doing inside the room, which is, you see, it's completely messed. Like, the particles are like wool, you know, wool fabric. It's chunks of dust particles. It is insane. I was sneezing and coughing because of this dust, but had to do it for you guys. So clean your system at least every month. Normally I would take out the graphic card. Radiator is the worst here. All those dust particles are inside of those fan blades. You see, it's so easy to clean with the air duster. Air duster, compressor, whatever you want to use it. That's the remote control for the RGB fans. I'm using Arctic P14 fans on top. Phenomenal fans, I love them, budget fans. But this case is too big if you ask me. Like, you have a glass panel on front also, you normally have a glass panel. But since I have the GPU on vertical direction, I ended up leaving it open. All of the cables are organized here, or most of them. 1000 watt PSU, old system with 3080 Ti 9900K processor, that should be updated. We'll see what I choose, I have plenty of options. And normally these fan blades are frosted. You probably hear somebody honking. Take a look at the other fan. It looks gray. They diffused RGB very nice, even though there's no RGB on them. So there's a light strip underneath, creates a very nice gentle color. It's horrible. Using a wet wipe here just to clean all of these fans. It works phenomenal. Normally sometimes I deattach them. I was lazy to do it. Vertical orientation on the GPU. I showed you guys how I done that part as well. Pump system is a little bit loose, that's why there's a fan supporting from underneath. She did all of the tubes. I mean, if I touch this system, I can improve it, but it's gonna get disassembled at some point pretty soon anyway. So there's no point doing it. But new hardware will be inside this system for sure. Pump and reservoir combo is from Gamingtech as well. It's glass reservoir, so it's quite heavy. Other than that, pretty basic system. 64GB of RAM, that's basically my editing machine. I was thinking, shall I do glass tubes in future? Who knows? It can happen. I just need a free time and stop messing with keyboards. But there's gonna be a lot of content. This is chilled video, me just cleaning the system. But take care of your hardware basically. Don't be like me, I did it for the sake of the video. And here, I try not to touch those plastic inserts there because there's a leak detector there. You can see how dirty the fan blades are here. And you gotta be careful with the leak detector as well, because it resets the system, thinking some water is leaking and stuff. Overall, very heavy case, huge case. It's called Gamingtech Anio. For those who are wondering about this case, I believe either 14 or 15 fans are installed on this system. Massive case. Bottom ones are just for the look, basically. RGB ones. RGB is insane on this system. It gets annoying. I don't know. I think I'm over RGB face. I try to turn off everything I can. Sadly, for the motherboard monoblock, you need to deattach that white cable, and those white cables, she could have done better job. So you guys can roast this system as much as you want, because I did not build this. I just use it. Ultra wide monitor here. I hope you enjoyed this video, guys. I'll see you on the next one. Like and share. Take care of yourselves. Let's go.